That was an incredible bridge for us and a new chapter to something that's going to be even greater and beyond. So she's not only an inspiration to all the Hmong girls and women in our community, but so much more than that. And I hope that she can continue to empower all the Hmong women and the girls in our community, because for several years, Hmong women in our community have strived and have done incredible things. And this was just sort of that pinnacle moment where that was realized globally. And so to all the Hmong women leaders who are in the building today, thank you guys for all coming out here. And I look forward to spending the day with you all.
Thank you, Rangoon no show on the Dr. Yang Dao. Ni show nya to fakite xiong yi xie jiu guo zhe zhou yi. Ya lu jian de dong gan da, ye ni yao hong hang ni te li sa dong zhi yi na jiao le show. Nu de bei mong xi ba jie wa. Lo da ge ni le tie. Zhong luo yo shao dong ge zu ge yi, za bei mong be mu zhou shong da li hai no xi ba jie wa.
愿神情不可以杀戮被蒙了你的大力不得说给你把天吧要给人和解答
This is provided to you by the Hmong TV Network, Tony Herr, HGED Media. So as we wait for Sunisa, she is here. She's going to be joining us here in a few minutes. We have a video production for her. There's a video show we want to put for you. A monitor will drop down, so we'll step out of the way for you guys to see that. In the meantime, while we wait for Sunisa to come up to the stage, we want to introduce just Tinu and I a little bit more about what we do. We know that working in our platform, in television news and mainstream media, there's not a lot of Hmong people in our newsrooms. And so it was a huge opportunity for both Tinu and I to be given these opportunities to work in newsrooms and to bring our voices and our stories and our perspectives, to bring these diverse voices into our newsrooms. I know for myself, when I first started in the industry 10 years ago, I was the only Hmong person for sure in my market and pretty much one of very few across the nation. And so it was very important for me to continue the work that we do so that we can continue to inspire other people to see, hey, that person looks like me on TV. I want to become, you know, and have the courage to get into newsrooms as well. And I know having the conversation about what is Hmong, who are Hmong, we've been having those conversations for as long as I can remember. And I know that once Sunisa won that Olympic gold, people started researching what the Hmong people are even more so. So I know this has been a huge opportunity, and I don't know what it was like for you, Chinu. What was it like for you when Sunisa won?
Yeah, it was a big deal for me when Sunisa won. I was still living in Atlanta at the time, and I was a reporter for NBC in Atlanta, and when she won, it was tremendous. I didn't know if it was real or not. I get the notification on my phone, and I kept looking at it, and I was so excited. And of course, being from St. Paul, I'm from St. Paul, it was unbelievable. It was a year ago yesterday that she won, and I went back and watched all the videos of her family celebrating. I watched her celebrating, I looked at the pictures, I looked at the parade, and it was just magnificent to see that. So I hope that all the young Hmong kids in here, I hope you guys take away from that is to be inspired and to just continue chasing whatever dreams that you have.
Yeah, I think this is an opportunity to really shed a light on the fact that what Sunisa is doing, she's paving the way. And I imagine she's not going to be the only one traveling to the Olympics to compete for themselves. We know tons of young gymnasts, like we heard from Senator Afong from Hmong Village this morning, saying that there are little girls coming to this country, arriving here from Thailand, from Laos, saying, "Who is? We want to be like Sunisa. We want to enter gymnastics to be just like her." And so she really is paving the way, and we want to honor her and recognize her hard work. It's not easy to do what she did, and so for all of us, just doing our best to continue to spread the word and to share our culture and our traditions and our people with our communities. I am encouraging all of you to go out into your communities, into your schools, to share who the Hmong are, our histories, our traditions, so that we can continue the story for years to come and for generations to come.
Okay, so
So I'm going to introduce a couple of honorable guest speakers we have today. And so just so we can acknowledge you before you speak later on in the program, while we wait for Sunisa and her family to come out here. So first off, we want to thank Mike Murphy, who is the mayor of the city of Lexington, for being here. Do you mind standing up if I read your name? So Mike Murphy is the mayor of Lexington. Thank you for joining us today.
We also have in our attendance today, we have Bob Fletcher, who is the Ramsey County Sheriff. Thank you, Sheriff Fletcher, for joining us. If you're here, please stand up so everyone can acknowledge you.
Oh, I guess. Okay, the screen's coming down. We're gonna step out of the way. Okay, let you play the video. So, you play the hello. Hi, Shachi is next.
Places where it was almost all over. 13.466 better than that is what she needs to take the lead. Here it comes, 13.7, Sumi Lee is the leader in the women's all-around. And Brazil has never had an Olympic medal in women's gymnastics. See in a moment if that changes. 13.666. And it's Sumi Lee who's in the top spot. She is going to win the Olympic all-around gold medal.
Welcome to the most exclusive gymnastics club, Sumi.
Get chills watching that, Sumi. I still remember exactly where I was, the moment I saw it, and how I felt. And I watched it back yesterday, and I still get chills watching that. So thank you so much for sharing that moment with us. It means a lot to us, and I still say this to this day. That was probably, as a native St. Paul kid, that was probably the most joyous day for us. So thank you for sharing that. I know we weren't as excited as Cheyenne watching that video, but we are thankful for it. So everyone, just give her another round of applause for being here. We give it your time. Thank you.
And I think we get emotional seeing that montage of all of the moments, because we see Sunisa's raw emotions with every step of the competition. Sunisa is a prime example of living that American dream. She was born here, had that American dream. Her parents, helped her achieve that American dream. And so, again, she's a wonderful example for all of us to know that you can have, that nothing is impossible. That if you work hard, you dedicate yourself, you have focus, you can make anything a reality.
All right, well, thank you.
Yes, no? Okay. I do not know.
เราจะมีการเต้เราจะมีสตาร์เราจะมีในสตาร์ก็หล่อต่อหอเซ็งพอเราเซ็งพอก็ยังเราเปลี่ยนหล่อต่อหอกระเฉงมงแต่เมื่อเจอมาก็ยังมองเราอย่างตัวยังต่อก็มามีจุดด้วนรุ่นหล่อสุดที่สั่งจุดด้วนรุ่นหล่อชัดเจนชัดชัยนะจุดด้วนรุ่นปียังเหมือนจะกล้าหล่อหล่อมากกว่าเฉยนอเอ็งรุ่นนอยังรุ่นนอมาหุ่นกันจุดด้วนรุ่นปีกระต้าขอก็หมดรุ่นเลยอีโต้ก็หมดถึงจู่อย่างนอรุ่นเนี่ยเต้ลังกินหนึ่งความดีสวัสดิ์ก็ดูหงโต้ฟ้าลงหัด 被洗脑了，多么了不起！我去我弟，我做做啥做晓得老家，晓得老婆了的。马古天，我古天那老胡家，搞些那木的花，这也木的种了。千里烟雾来，那些烟雾香。他怕那个大马步，要求八个民族多住上了，说话我心里不打。到了天，我这计划天，有个中产老弟天，他怕那个说个大马了，说话呢，得搞到这老国家的战风，老家的全民家，老家就可以呢。现在又到了，英国没得法呢，英国没得法。爸爸说你上面就端住老这样呢不知道不能引动妈妈搞不到妈了草母呢说我不知道说了草母搞着干了都没干的没干的呢我不能去没干要到老没干的我没你说大呢我在大哥我弄家里的我这边就要干弄弄了也弄不弄了也弄差弄了也弄差老早没人是大尿生活的老早生活我就梦了有个蛋糕肚有个这个姐呢哎呀过啊帮我吃你傻了之后把我解散抽到了我要煮包了之后把我解散包了之后把我弄省了要省我钱念钱见我刚带过带了就老是应该去包了之后把我解省了省我钱去定期搞了多少钱几天省呢省过呢要省好点他一里人不再给老姐人了参谋的他老了说呢参刀嘛跑嘛刀给着后爸嘛我就是的那种先捞了天被参谋关注着就飞的包了着后爸带你来着后节目那我这呢家个痛了是的呢你说的八婆子罗你叫老叫的你吃得很点冷得都拉得要老你要被谁的路歇了就被谁的路来了呢我的脑呢哇被给你弄上这给不被说的脑你要再说把这你让我提供你被谁的
For those of you trying to understand what's happening up here, this is a very traditional celebration where we're doing a string tying blessing for Sunisa and all of her accomplishments. In our culture, we have elders that speak asking for her continued health and success and to remind her that she has a home here in America with not only her Hmong community, but also with her American family as well here in America as she's born and raised here. What they're doing is they're bringing a string and connecting all of us here in this room so that we can continue to bless and give all of these blessings to Sunisa up front here.
Embassy Suni, clap really loud.
Okay, Sunisa, Shenzhou Lama,我晓得是呢。哦，是你上，你那打着的脑袋去，得去得得得为点叫，专门晓得做呢，晓得走路呢，也晓得走路呢，路苦路工路忙，我要把家里生给住给老，我老多好不少。对，这这梦想的叫老天都告诉侬，去学业，去学书，去用功，去用脑，去到中爱中脑， ที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ยเราที่เราคืนเราปีที่เราเนี่ย
สุริสายาเป็นตัวไทยมงลีซึ่งสุริสายาตั้งทำให้จงมงเฉลิมตัวไทยเนื้อมงอเมริกา 你要说几多的钱，你讲我不得钱过，跟我没完，没吃饭，要找点对呢。哎，侬呢？啊，你说的五百零五号路呀？被解蒙的时候，被什么的其他是被我，你说的走啊？你到多参加，被都采蒙了，搞路公路被转着，让我们这被路那个也当得是，好当去跑给融资还要找一头头，要当他做被蒙America。
那我一考还我投入些好，我身体还落后，只能做着那些的。那忙哎，别去做新路，我把那点投入些好。哎，等你菜让你到菜路给过了。过了，老家伙家那太多，那太多，那户的户都过了家了，么都用些过嘛，就要得提些过。
我嘛要花点用些货呢，那可能要一块点用，但是到家了你哈，我都还路陪你家了么多，但是空天都你还在家都能够去走路还得都能得，一路都多了，老要一直过那几号哩，没有那个路都路得怎么点的，少的家路你都还着被走还不得家了被人家用些，当然这些我也别帮得不着。
罗阿爹，脑子多少种人一度，百多点头发没了，百种手艺就多少种人一愣，但是百种手艺人，弄弄着啊，你那不要多多家里给家，出门到我百种的上了，我出到门要还能用吃不了，伢种点点那几个人在家有用吃门的，哎呦啊，今天到天那鬼么就给那家老爸的那天。 哎，你好，这补贴你好，不要路边都拆的，路边还弄的，就差些些地了，别就是些路，我找路人找那个，别还弄呢，路边也住房门，也住着，几年路都要住个别，你怎么个？
那在那不老古早，我叫人家，打他，啊，叫个米的，那多人帮嘛，那可以去洗了去，别去打点那个，打那比较猛啊，多呢，把车洗一下，啊，我讲的了，打那比较猛，多了，干多了嘞，那些的，那就跑了，一路，一路把车弄走，后来啊，被猛一阵啊，古董菜了嘛。 我这个半年有一次，炒那个冬笋没老钱，但想着我到啊，一考高中的毕业梦那些，只能摸着一样，啊，打了毕业梦都拆了，那车嘛，把车弄掉，都拆弄掉，啊，一看这，我啊，压力紧张啊，啊，古董拆了的话，天啊，我礼拜。 梦的，梦也没老多的，都做了多了，用了做了，你吃上了梦的，再去到一老了，你也拿了去啊，点的要梦啊，你自己点的要梦啊，只要等你吃上了，是再点，我家都老就要了，你吃饱呀，点，吃了一两次。
Okay, so thank you, John. Dina Pepe, ask Suni Salim, it's okay, just a couple of words. We need to hear from some women too, you know? So.
สุนิสาเนี่ยอ่าช่วงเช้าเดี๋ยวนู้นนี่เช้าเราเขาตัวเช้าอ่าสุนิสาเนี่ยอ่าชอบเล่นจัตุไอ้ภาษาว่าช่วงนั้นเราเจ้าก็มีดีแล้วยังเดียวจ้อยอ่าเราว่าเขาเลยเช้าเช้าเราลุยแม่นั่งก่อนเนาะเขาตัวเป็นเสือตัวเนี่ยเนาะอ่าสาวเป็นสุนิสาโน้ตเนี่ยอ่าช่วงเช้าเดี๋ยวนี้เช้าเราชอบเล่นจัตุตัวป้าเป๋ยอ่าสาวเป๋ย
Thank you so much. Okay, so this next thing, Dino Bayo, Yelko, Sunisa, Nepitine, and Hamujo, don't, Sunisa, if you don't mind staying up here, they're going to do a little presentation for you. So I'll have Laura explain that a little bit.
You present a gift award for Sunisa. And you have the chairperson of the committee that's organizing this wonderful event today. On behalf of the Hmong Committee, the Global Empowerment Day Committee, they're gifting Sunisa a Hmong hat to bestow the fact that she's a now a Hmong American icon.
Wow, that looks so awesome.
Shanaa Tupeng, we're going to have a performance for you. Bok Tao. Bok Tao is going to perform a live song from Laos.
Thank you. 对呀，早起的不多嘛，有一种菜是那是咖喱，只不过是呀，这么多说到非洲，但它被种梦。Ya, mohon tuan tuan beri niat dikira ni cara sedar. Sosia tuan beri tunggai sumi sali. Tuan tuan yang mohon tuan mojo, dia tu jauh beri mong nung beri mui kau tuan tuan di nanti. Dia kau beri cuma tuan jauh jauh tuan kala. Kau mohon sumi sali, sumi sali nak. Woi tu kau jauh beri cuma sedar. Woi jauh nanti tuan jantan mohon dia jauh sedar dulu nanti sedar. Mohon tifi lu sedar kau jala.มองกิลูเชียก็สิ่งเดียวสิยินดีกับท่านแต่เนี่ยฉันเลยมองไปมาชิ้นชิ้นตัวจะโดนหรือลูเชียท่านแต่เนี่ยฉันเลยจะซื้อเหล้าเท่าจะจานุ่งหนาเท่าเนี่ยสิ่งที่ฉันเนี่ยฉันเลยท่านใจเนี่ยฉันเลยมัวจบเกินเอาหรือเราลูร้องเราสุนิสาลีฮัตเตียก็ก็เราหายไปจนมองไม่เห็นหรอกก็พิจารณาสิ่งที่นิจฉาฉันเลยลูเชียเสียหน้าท่านจบกันท่าน
Okay, what y'all do your part on stream live for people they do. Okay, Dina move you we're going to hear from All right, here she comes. Woo! Who's excited?
Growing up, I never thought that a little girl from Eastside, St. Paul, who flipped around on a homemade balance beam from my dad for fun, would be standing in front of all of you today. These past 2 years have truly changed me, and these experiences that I've gotten from the Olympics are truly life-changing and opportunities of a lifetime. My world changed overnight after winning gold at the Olympics. It's crazy to think 1 year ago today, I won the Olympic gold.What many people don't know is that I almost quit, like many of you here. The pandemic took away many opportunities for me, especially access to training for what I have been working on since I was 12. With the pandemic, Tokyo was pushed back and I was unfortunately not allowed to have my parents there. And that was difficult because they were there for every meet. I truly felt like my life was over because I wasn't allowed to train.But with the help of my support system, determination, and self-belief, I was able to accomplish what I did. I had to remind myself of the passion I felt for the sport. And once I did, that fueled everything. I don't spend a single moment not feeling incredibly thankful and humbled for those who helped me get here. I'd like to thank my entire family, my mom and dad especially, for sacrificing everything for me in order to achieve my dreams.And I would also like to thank every member of the Hmong community, all of you here today, for sacrificing, supporting, and continuously pushing and believing in me at every step of the journey. To anyone who has reached out and sent me a kind message, I see you. I'm so grateful that our community could come together today and celebrate. Your support does not go unnoticed, and I hope to continue to make you all proud. To all of the young children in here,I hope that I can continue to inspire all of you to reach your dreams. This journey has been a dream come true, and I know it's only just the beginning. Thank you all for allowing me to be a voice to inspire and for letting me represent the Hmong community. This day is to not only to celebrate me and my achievements, but to allow our community to come together and celebrate as one. Thank you.
No.